Hey friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. And I welcome you all in this series of morning tales, which is for your phase 1 exams of RBI, SEBI and NABARD. So guys, SEBI exam is just around the corner, and those who are preparing for this exam, I would like them to wish them all the best for their exam preparation. Now let's begin this series, which is very helpful for your examination if you are preparing for any kind of banking examination. But the students who are coming for the first time, do subscribe and hit the bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes as well as resolve your queries. So here we are at our first question. Where is India's first hot air balloon wildlife safari in a tiger reserve launched? So basically, it is the first time that the first hot air balloon safari, wildlife safari, has been launched in India in a tiger reserve. So where has it been launched? So it is launched in option E, Bandhavgarh Tiger Reserve. Now guys, where is this tiger reserve located? Do you know that? If you don't know this, then do find it out. And if you know it, then do tell me in the comment section below. Remember this thing: wildlife sanctuaries, tiger reserves, biosphere reserves, national parks are all the topics of static GK as well. So you should be well aware of these things, that where is which tiger reserve located. Now, since it is in the news, therefore there are high chances that it can be asked in the examination. So do find it out and tell me that in which state is it located. Now, as far as this question is concerned, let me tell you that there is nothing much to be discussed here. It's just that it is first hot air balloon wildlife safari. So now you can watch the animals at a height. So if you are interested, you can visit it by next year. Okay, so we have the second first of the day. Which state has announced to set up India's first mega leather park? Remember this thing, guys, that it is still in its planning stage. That means that is that the state government has announced that it is going to set up this mega leather park. Now, which state has done so? It is Uttar Pradesh. Again, nothing much. Just remember this thing, that the state is planning to launch this mega leather park in Kanpur. So this place is important. Kanpur is the place, is the exact location where this mega leather park is going to be established, or is perceived to be, or we can say that it is planned to be established in Kanpur. Third first of the day. So in which state will India's first lithium refinery be established? So this lithium refinery, lithium is used for manufacturing lithium ion batteries. And what is the purpose of these lithium ion batteries? The purpose is to use them in the e vehicles, in e cars or e vehicles, whatever there is. So the e vehicles run on these lithium ion batteries, and this refinery will convert the lithium ore into the batteries. So this is going to be India's first lithium refinery, and where is it going to be established? In Gujarat. Now, related to lithium only, there is another first in Gujarat, and that is the first lithium manufacturing plant, lithium battery manufacturing plant. So what is the name of that? It is TDS. Battery Manufacturing Gujarat Private Limited, which is located in Gujarat basically. So this TDS is an acronym for the companies that have launched this manufacturing plant. So T stands for Toshiba Corporation, D for Denso Corporation, and C for Suzuki Motor Corporation. And all these companies laid the foundation stone of this manufacturing plant back in the year 2017. But it is going to be operational by the year 2021. So that's all. This is another first related to lithium, as which is in the same state where the India's first lithium refinery is also being planned. So remember these two things related to this question. Which of the following app has been launched by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs to handle the business of premise allotment for different occasions? So basically, let me first clear this question to you. A portal as well as basically a website as well as a mobile application has been launched by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. And this portal aims to allocate the land or for different purposes. For example, the government land for residential purposes, the government land for office space to government organization, the government land for different kinds of party or different kinds of occasions. So basically, all the land allotment work that is done by the government has been put on one portal. So what is the name of that portal or the mobile app? So it is the same name. That is e-sampada. So sampada in English means wealth. So from here you can remember it that e-sampada is the portal that is related to this land allocation or the premise allocation work of Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So that's all for this question. But my question for you is that who is the Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs? So do tell it in the comment section below. Okay, guys, this is an important news from the international news section of Spotlight magazine. So do listen to me very carefully. Which is the only Indian institution to feature in the Nature AI Index 2020? So guys, before answering this question, I would like to shed light on this index itself. So this Nature AI Index, AI stands for Artificial Intelligence. So this index is released by Nature Research. Nature Research released this index, and this index measures the performance of countries, of a total number of 25 countries towards AI development, artificial intelligence development. And in which manner does this index measures the performance of countries? Basically, it measures the performance of countries in terms of publication of research papers in a particular field like AI. So how many research papers are there that have been published by India? On the basis of that, India will be ranked in this index, which has a total number of 25 countries. Okay, so remember this thing, research articles. Now guys, in order to rank or assess the countries, the index has two categories basically. So this is a little technical portion of this index, but do remember this thing because it will make it easier for you to remember the entire factual metrics of this index. Okay, so there is one category called count and the other category is share. So in this count category, the total number of articles published by a country or an institution has been ranked, and this share category ranks a country on the basis of total number of articles launched collaboratively or shared in the international arena. So basically these two are the categories of this index. Now guys, individual rankings have been given to countries and institutions in both these categories. So basically, we have four index tables to be remembered. First is count countries, basically the ranking of countries in count, then ranking of institutions in count category, then ranking of countries in share category, then ranking of institutions in share category. So in this manner, we have four different rankings. But do not worry here, because there are not many facts that you have to mug up. There, I have picked up a selected number of facts so that it will become easier for you, as well as the important facts are there only. So now let us discuss those facts. So as I mentioned, 25 countries were there that were assessed. Top three countries in terms of research papers published on AI from 2015 to 2019. So this is the count category. Countries in count category. So countries mein first is China, then US and India is on the third number with 91,563 article published. Now we have top four countries in terms of total article share in the field from 2015 to 2019. So this ranking is topped by US, UK, then we have Germany at the third number and China is at the fourth number. So remember this thing, in terms of total publication, China is at the top, but in terms of article share, China is at the fourth and India has dropped down to 20th rank. So India's rank is 20th here. Remember this thing. Now next is institutions. So the total 100 institutions, top 100 institutions in terms of total article published, that is count. From 2015 to 2020. So the first ranker here is Tsinghua University. Then we have University of Chinese Academy of Sciences, Shanghai Jiao Tong University. So all these three universities belong to China. Then we have Anna University from Chennai, which is the only Indian institution in the list at 32nd rank. So here the answer of our question is answered. The answer is Anna University. Top 100 institutions in artificial intelligence in terms of total article share in the field. So here Harvard University is at first, Stanford second, Massachusetts Institute of Technology is at third. All are from USA. No Indian institute is on this list. So remember this thing. These are some of the facts related to this index. I hope that now this index is easier for you to remember. And the answer is Anna University. Option C. Now our next question is, who has won the ICC Spirit of Cricket Award of the decade 2020? So ICC is International Cricket Council. It has given the Spirit of Cricket Award of the decade 2020. Now who has won this award? It is MS Dhoni. Nothing much to be discussed here. It's just a static question. It's just a very simple question, but a static question is following this question. So the static question is, where is the headquarters of this ICC? So this is your task. Do tell me in the comment section below. Whose autobiography is titled as In Pursuit of Justice, an Autobiography? So the answer of this question is option E, Rajinder Sachar. So do remember his name. Autobiographies like this can be asked in the examination. So do not think of ignoring these questions. Okay. Now this session here ends here. I hope that you have enjoyed it. And if you have, then do share it and spread the knowledge. Thank you so much for watching this video. And do watch it tomorrow as well.